Claire de Lune. Is it worth a buy? Let's read the words. On Steam. Claire de Lune is a story-driven puzzle-adventure game set in a grounded science fiction universe. You play as John, a smuggler on the run with his daughter Claire, after some unknown force causes them to crash-land their spaceship on a foreign planet. John is separated from Claire. He must use his ingenuity, agility, blind f***ing luck, and a few handy pieces of technology to find Claire, repair his ship, and escape safely. Yes, guys, this is a puzzle-driven story adventure game. That's what the developers say. Myself, I find it a very frustrating, not so good game, guys. And I'm going to show you why. The story, let's start with the story. Okay, that's perfectly feasible. Her escape pod crashes somewhere on the planet. You've got to try and find her. Yeah, I'm all for that. That's a good little plot right there. And it twists and turns as you go on. You're talking to this AI that's kind of guiding you and annoying you with the dialogue. It's one of, you know what the trouble with the dialogue in this? It's kind of like modern movies. There's never any time for being serious. Everything's a fucking joke. Everything. It doesn't matter how serious the situation, it's just a smart ass fucking joke. That's why modern movies absolutely blow. They are fucking awful. Because it doesn't matter what it is, whether it's a thriller, whether it's a superheroes movie, a dinosaur movie, whatever it is, it's irrelevant. A situation will be absolutely fucking dire, but all the cast are too busy being smart ass fucking jokery around. And that's what separates the great movies from the 80s and 90s from modern fucking trash. Because back in the day with games and movies, we knew when to be a smart ass and when to be serious. Now, nobody fucking knows anything. And it's all just smart assery left, right, and just get on with it.
Fun fact, the energy view conveniently highlights large sources of energy, ignoring smaller sources for ease of use.
That fun fact was actually somewhat helpful, Arturo.
Oh, they're all helpful. Remember the one about the Cerulean arms dealers? That one practically saved your life.
Saved my life? You told me they liked hamburgers.
Yeah, and then you bought them some hamburgers, and they liked them. Who knows what would have happened if you served them those Corvian meat pies you wanted instead?
I doubt they would have murdered me for serving them meat pies.
Oh, yeah? Fun fact, in 2177, a man on Beta Corvino murdered a patron of Tino's Patty Shack over a meat pie-related dispute.
I take it back. Your fun facts are terrible.
So you go around trying to find clues to where Claire is, and you have to do some little kind of puzzles in that. And you know what? Hats off to the developers of this. The puzzles aren't basic, easy stuff like we have seen in recent games like Resident Evil and that. The puzzles in this are a little bit more difficult, but still pretty easy. What isn't easy, though, are the platforming mechanics of this game. You have this gun, and it can produce a square that you can jump on, a little trampoline that boosts you, and you can put the square on that and get an even bigger boost. And it also fires this thing at flat surfaces, which is just like a beam that comes out, and you can fire a cube into that to jump onto. That's all I've unlocked. I haven't finished the game. I'm exactly halfway through it, and I can't play it anymore. I'm just done with it completely. Because it's the mechanics of every single... All I've done is run around looking at cliffs and working out how to get from one side of them to another by bouncing off the little purple thing, jumping on the little blue thing, or flying across on the little beamy thing. And it's just... It's a dying simulator. It's a dying simulator. This game should be called Claire de Dying Simulator, because that's what you do. You come across an area and you think, how do I get across there? Well, it's easy. You die 5,000 times until the penny drops, and then you just do that. Half the time I've actually glitched across the areas. But you know why I really don't like this game? It's because you can see ledges that you can easily walk on. But when you try, there's an invisible force field. I'm sorry you're not allowed on this ledge. But why? Why it's there? The ledge is there. I should be allowed on it because there's the fucking ledge and I got onto it. No, you can't. You're not allowed on that. We're pushing you off with this invisible force field. You've got to do it our way. There is some monsters in this barren world. Not many. There's these little spiders that you have to kind of avoid, or they just jump on your face at the speed of sound. There's also a big guy who chases you around. That was the funnest part of the game, to be honest. Having to do parkour kind of trampolining while this big guy who can also jump around is chasing you. That was the only real good part of the game. I don't know what lies ahead in the second half of the game, and I never will, because I just cannot stand the game the way it is. It's just, I mean, it's not an awful game. It's just boring and frustrating. And I've said this 1,000 times when you're making a game. If the game becomes more frustrating than it is fun, well, I'm sorry, but it's not going to do very well. And this game is an excellent example of frustration over fun. You will be way more frustrated than you will have fun. And that, for me, is when I'm out. I've given it a few hours. I've given it about 4.8 hours to get halfway through the game. Died over 200 times, I would say. And it's just a frustrating game. See, for me, I thought it was going to be a bit like Portal. It's clearly inspired from Portal, but it just lacks everything that Portal had. That's the problem with it. And it's a shame, because, you know, I don't like dissing games like this when you can see that they've put in hours and hours of years of work to get this. I mean, it doesn't look too bad at all, but, you know, at the end of the day, it's my job to give my opinion, because that's all reviews are, opinions. And in my opinion, it's just a frustrating game. A very, very, very overly frustrating game. It should have had way more going on in the world instead of this barren planet. And, you know, at the end of the day, when all the things that you have to do is just get across chasm after chasm after chasm, there's not really much else going on. The platforming kind of puzzles are just so basic. That's all I've done. Literally, that's all I've done in 4.8 hours. Just get from chasm to chasm. And I can't express how soul-destroying it is when you spend 15 minutes, you die 30 times, and you finally figure it out, and you get up and you think, thank goodness for that. And then you walk 5 feet and you see another chasm that you know is going to kill you at least 20 or 30 times. And then you'll do that one, and then that'll take you 10 minutes, 20 deaths. And then you'll walk another 10 foot and see another exactly kind of the same thing, you know. And it's just, nah, I'm sorry. That is not fun. Not in my world anyway. Such a shame.